Hi, I'm Kathy from Applique Corner, and I'm here today with my dear friend, Debbie Homer-Hofhines from R&K Distributing from the Floriani division. We're here today to talk about stabilizers. Have you ever stabilized a project and it didn't turn out quite the way you wanted? Well, I think we all have. Well, Debbie specializes in teaching and educating us all in stabilizers, and she is here today to share a wealth of information. So sit back and enjoy.
It is great to be here, Kathy. I'm so excited that you asked me to come. I mean, what a great opportunity and honor for me to be here with you. So thank you. And of course, there isn't anything that I love any more than to be able to share my knowledge and everything that I get to learn on the Floriani products. So it'll be great to share this with your people.
Well, we're very excited about it. Thank you for being here.
Well, thank you for asking me. What an honor. There is never too much information to give, and I think probably the hardest thing is to be able to try to get it all out. I think I always ask everybody, my first question is, have you ever had an embroidery project that didn't turn out absolutely perfect?
We all have.
Oh my gosh, and it's all about stabilizing, truly it is. And if we don't use a kind of stabilizer that go with the right kind of fabric and for the stitch count, then of course our projects aren't going to turn out the way they should. There's three things that might help your people, and by the way, I love your designs, and being able to see what you have created is absolutely awesome, Kathy.
Well, thank you so much.
They're gorgeous.
I appreciate
absolutely
that.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
There's three things that I always start teaching when I do events and do crowds of women. And the first one is, how many of you are looking very first when you pull your design up for the stitch count? And the reason I ask that question, Kathy, is because I never did.
Yep.
I don't really care what the stitch count is. I just want to see this baby start stitching out.
Right.
I want to see the colors. Right. I want to see how beautiful it is. Mm-hmm. So if we will always, first of all, look at the stitch count, that stitch count tells us how much stabilizer we need to use. Now the second thing, if for a rule of thumb, the next thing you're going to look at after you've determined that stitch count of that design is, what are you going to put it on to?
Right.
Your base. Yep. What kind of fabric? Mm-hmm. Is it going to be a tightly woven fabric? Is it going to be a fabric that has any stretch or any give to it? So that is definitely important, because that will tell us what kind of stabilizer needs to go with that particular fabric.
Right.
Then of course the third thing will be determine our stabilizers. So one, the stitch count. Two, the base we're going to put the embroidery design onto. And then the third, the stabilizer we're going to use.
Well, I'm excited to hear about it.
All right. Well, we're going to share some fun things with you, because embroidery has definitely changed over the years.
Yes, it has.
Oh my goodness. And what we can accomplish now is absolutely amazing. So I thought we'd start with water solubles. Is that all right?
Yes, that sounds good.
Okay. So I don't know if you've ever made freestanding lace before or not. But freestanding lace can be so much fun, and I just kind of stitched out some lace samples here for you, Kathy, so you can kind of look at them.
Those are beautiful.
And isn't it amazing that you can actually take just a piece of stabilizer and create these beautiful pieces of lace? So nice. This product is called our Wet and Gone, and I'm going to let you hold those for a second, Kathy, because I have got a sample here, a roll of our Wet and Gone, and this is the Wet and Gone water-soluble stabilizer. Now, what this means is, when we talk about a water-soluble stabilizer, it's going to wash away with water. Now, I don't know if you have used water solubles on the market before, but I've been doing this a long time, and I can tell you that there are many water solubles out there that are very difficult to rinse out. Oh my gosh, I have taken and actually soaked these babies overnight. I've even put them in the microwave before trying to get them hot enough to rinse this out.
To rinse it out. Yeah.
So you won't have to do that with Wet and Gone. It's the most fabulous, fabulous water-soluble stabilizer.
That's good to hear.
When you stitch out your lace, normally, if your lace is not really heavy and dense, you can get by with just one layer of Wet and Gone.
Okay.
After you've stitched it out, then I just take and trim off the excess. I'm literally going to take and just rinse this under lukewarm water, Kathy. Doesn't have to be hot.
Wow.
And the other thing that I do is I don't rinse it all out. I like my lace, if you'll notice, there's some body left in there.
There is.
So I don't rinse everything out. And when this dries, you don't see any stabilizer inside because the stabilizer just dries and absorbs into the fibers of the thread. So that's the beauty of Wet and Gone, is you can literally wash out as much or as little as you want and not have to worry about getting it all out. Once you rinse this out, I'll take a paper towel. I'll put this down on a paper towel and put another one on top and just simply blot out the water. But whatever you do, don't leave it on the paper towel to dry because it's still sticky.
Let it stick.
Or otherwise, your paper towel is going to become part of your lace. All right? So be sure after you blot that water out, just pull it off the paper towel and then just put it on your counter and let it dry.
Well, I love the fact that it has some body to it. If you were going to take one of the pieces of freestanding lace to another project or garment and stitch it on, you won't be fussing and fighting with those edges and trying to, as if it were, you know, flimsy. So that's really nice.
Very true.
Debbie, would you use the same stabilizer for the cut work?
Yes,
at Applique Corner,
definitely.
We have some cut work designs.
Definitely. And the great thing about this too, Kathy, is it comes in a tacky.
Great.
So if you need the tacky, the sticky part, still water soluble, still going to wash away.
Because cut work is basically freestanding lace, similar, right?
Right. Yep. That's exactly what it is.
Very nice.
A little hint, when you do freestanding lace, not a lot of people understand, and they've had this wonderful little mishap happen. When you stitch all this out, it's important when you look at your lace design that it says freestanding or standalone.
Right.
Because if it's not, that means it's not been digitized to be able to hold together and intersect those stitches. And then when you wash out your stabilizer,
it'll all fall apart.
That's exactly right. So you have a clump of thread in your hands after you have this beautiful stitch out.
That's right.
So be sure your design sets stand alone or freestanding.
Right.
And then you can just accommodate beautiful, beautiful laces.
Well, these are just lovely. I appreciate you sharing them with us.
They are. They're a lot of fun to do. Now, also, let's just kind of move this one aside because I'm going to share with you one that I think is a lot of fun too. And I really didn't find ever a use for it until just recently. It's still Wet and Gone, because we're still talking about water soluble, but Wet and Gone also comes in a fusible. Now, I used to think, why would I need a fusible Wet and Gone? And if you were going to do like maybe a really sheer scarf, it might be nice to fuse that onto that sheer fabric so that it wouldn't slide and move on you. But here's one that I found that I thought was just the greatest invention ever. And Kay shared this with me, and it was just the greatest idea. Needle turn applique. Have you ever heard of needle turn applique?
I actually have not.
So most of your designs are probably raw edged applique, right?
Right.
Okay, so there's a lot of like block of the months and designers out there that have literally needle turn. So that means that your seam allowance has to be a perfect quarter of an inch all the way around.
Nice.
So you take your needle and thread and you sew precisely, push that under a perfect quarter of an inch all the way around. Now, it doesn't work for me. Number one, I'm allergic to handwork. My motto is, if it can't be done on the machine, it doesn't need to be done in my book. All right? So, but it is beautiful. And so here's a great idea. So Kay showed this to me and I thought, oh my goodness, this is the coolest thing ever. Take your heart, cut out your shape. Take your Wet and Gone fusible and cut it out at the same time.
Okay.
When you lay this on here, make sure that the fusible part, you can see the shiny, see the fusible? Okay,
sure,
so when you lay this down, make sure your fusible is looking at you.
Okay.
Okay, so it's gonna be on top. And we're gonna lay this on the right side of our heart. Now, most all of our machines now have that wonderful quarter inch foot that gives you that guide to go all the way around.
Yes.
Okay. So you're going to sew your perfect quarter of an inch seam all the way around this.
Okay.
When we get all done, of course, we've enclosed this. We're just going to pull this apart and take and make a slit right up the middle of this on our Wet and Gone. And then we're going to take and turn this.
How smart is that?
I know. I'm like, oh my gosh. Light bulbs went off like crazy. Now, there is a tool that we're doing that I'm very excited about that R&K will have in the next few months. That kind of looks like a knitting needle. And I was on the instigation of designing this because I had one from years ago. But you can take and run that all along your seam allowance, because you know when you turn these, you have to take your needle and try to pull this out so you get this perfect. Well, this is going to push that all out, kind of pressing that on its own. So then when you turn it and you press this, it's beautiful.
It is.
And you have a perfect quarter an inch all the way around it. One
that
little trick
I'm
going to tell you is don't steam it. And why do you think I'm telling you that? This is a water soluble.
Yep.
So if you steam it, what happens? It just goes, shrivels it all up, okay? So just press it, and then it makes it nice and even. Isn't that awesome? Now you can see my slit back there.
Yeah.
I kind of tried to not press it all the way down so you could
see. What a helpful tip. Thank you.
It's a great little tip. I think it's absolutely awesome.
Very nice.
So then again, you could take and you could do a blanket stitch, or if you have right kind of software, you could even scan this in and make it do it right in your embroidery hoop.
That would be nice.
Okay. All right. All right. So then also Wet and Gone comes in a sticky. Now, there are many times, Kathy, that it would be impossible to actually try to hoop.
Yes.
So you need something to go in your hoop to be able to stick it to. So I have a t-shirt here. And of course, it would be impossible to hoop this because of the way the neckline is. So by taking and using a sticky in the hoop, a water soluble, then we have something to stick it to. Of course, we want to be able to prep our t-shirt first. And we'll talk about knits here in just a little bit. And what we would actually use to prep that first. But Wet and Gone Tacky is wonderful to put in the hoop to have something to put down to, so that we can actually embroider onto this because of the neckline. Now, Wet and Gone Tacky, you hoop this up with the shiny side up.
Okay.
And if you turned it over, you would actually be able to see the Wet and Gone on the back. So still using Wet and Gone, but we just put a tacky base onto it. So you can tell that I've hooped it up with an extra inch around, at least, all the way around. And I've just got a little T-pin here, and I'm just going to put this on the table, because all we're going to do, Kathy, is going to take and just score this from corner to corner.
Okay.
And then I'm just going to come back to the center, and I'm going to lift, and I'm just going to pull this paper off. Then I'm going to do that all the way around till I have all of the sticky exposed. Now, if you get a little carried away sometimes, and on Wet and Gone Tacky, it's not that easy to do. If you were to score all the way through, you can patch it. Yes, and don't think I haven't done that before, so, all right. Okay, so let's get
this is such a helpful method for all of those items that you can't hoop, just like you were showing the neckline there, but there are all sorts of items, sometimes a bag or a garment that you can't fit in the hoop, or if you're getting close to the edge. Now, you mentioned an inch all the way around. That's what's recommended, isn't that right?
It is, and I may be a little shy. I'm close on this side, but you really want to make sure you have enough in there.
Right.
I mean, I've had women that are telling me they're pulling all of the paper off and then trying to hoop that with a sticky, and I'm, how on earth can you get that center hoop down in there? That would be like a nightmare.
That would be.
So you don't need to do it. And just by scoring like I did, and notice I didn't even go all the way around, Kathy. I just did an X. Now, here's a little trick that I use, and we didn't bring a quilter's ruler with us to measure, to make this, but I'm going to show you. We're going to pretend that my line's perfectly straight, all right? Every marking, or every hoop has markings. So you not only have vertical, but you have horizontal.
Right.
And when you have these markings on the hoop, this side and this side are not always perfectly symmetrical.
I've run into that.
Yes, and we all do.
Yeah.
And usually the hard way.
Okay? The hard way.
So there is a mark that tells you at the top of the hoop. So this center hoop, make sure, and I've even taken and put a black X with a little fine tip black magic marker on both hoops so that I make sure I get this lined up right, because if I get in a hurry, which, you know. All right, so now that I have this hooped up, I want to find exactly the center of this hoop. So we're gonna pretend that I have a quilter's ruler, since I don't, and I'm just using a heat friction pen.
Okay.
All right. Yes. Now, I wouldn't use an ink pen because an ink could come off onto your garment or your project, your fabric, and then you couldn't get the ink off.
Well, Debbie, will you tell the ladies what a heat friction pen is?
I would love to. Good idea. These are the most incredible marking pens ever. They've been out for maybe 3 years or so. They come in a fine tip pen, also in a felt tip marker. And what they are is they make a mark for you for placement, but it goes away with the heat of an iron. Now, this is kind of funny because you need to know that if you mark all your blocks and you press your seams open, your markings are going to go away. But if you stick them in the freezer, your marks will all come back, believe it or not.
Believe it or not.
Don't go to Alaska, though, and walk around, you know. You make sure you wash it first. All right, so these are heat friction pens, and they come in lots and lots of colors.
Nice.
They have a really nice little fine tip. This is the best marking pen ever. I love these. Yep. So we're going to pretend that Debbie has a ruler and line this up with the markings, all right? So we're just going to hope that Debbie can do a fairly straight, hey, not too
hey,
bad, actually.
Not bad.
Whoa. I'm not sure we can see it on the camera. I'm hoping that it's dark enough there that you can actually see it. Okay, now I'm going to go the other direction as well, and at least I think you can see what we're trying to accomplish. And I'll make this a little darker here so we can hopefully see this on the camera. So now, Kathy, why did I do that?
I don't know.
Okay. Now we know exactly where the center of the hoop is.
That's right.
Right. So now we know where the center of the hoop is. Wouldn't we need to do the same thing to our t-shirt or whatever it is we were going to put on
here? Yes.
So after we would prep our fabric, then of course we would definitely want to do exactly the same thing. And this has been washed so many times, my lines are gone. But we'll just go ahead and pretend.
Okay.
We'll go ahead and draw this placement line. Let's see if we can get this to go through here. Because you have to determine where the center of that design is going to be.
Correct.
And then we're going to pretend that it's going to go this way. Now, by marking this on the back, it makes it really easy to put it onto our wetengun tacky. So I'm going to simply fold it on the center line. And I'm going to line it up on the center line of my wet and gone tacky.
Yeah.
Now, Kathy, I've got a line going this way and I have a line going this way. So it's going to be absolutely perfect, isn't
That's right. It is.
How many times have you hooped up a t-shirt and you've had to re-hoop?
Too many to count.
Oh my gosh. This is the slickest way ever.
Nice.
Because it's going to be perfect the very first time. So I can literally fold this up here. Double checking, and it's right on the money.
Nice.
Of course, I can come back this way, and I can double check to make sure, and I'm right on the money. And I don't know if the camera, I'll fold this up so the camera can see. So now that I know that this is all absolutely lined up, I'm going to take and smooth this all out. Get this all out of the way here. So I would smooth this all onto my sticky, and it's lined up perfect, absolutely perfect. Now here's something that really your ladies need to know is every time you use a sticky stabilizer, don't rely upon the sticky stabilizer to hold this all by itself. You really want to use that awesome basting feature in your machine. Almost every machine has it now. And it's a built-in basting stitch in the embroidery mode on your machine. So a lot of machines, for instance, like Baby Lock, and we're going to mention Baby Lock since they're so gracious to loan us these incredible machines that we get to use. And it's when you go to the sewing mode, after you go into the sewing mode, on the new Destiny, you have to go to the embroidery mode. When you go to the embroidery mode, you simply click on the edit. And when you click on edit, it'll come up with a little box with a flower with little dots all the way around it. You cannot find that basting feature till after you go into embroidery mode. And every machine is different. Some machines have called what is a fixed stitch, and so it's the same thing as a basting feature. There's even softwares, and of course our Floriani software has a built-in basting stitch that you can incorporate it right into part of the embroidery design.
Well, Debbie, I'll tell you, if you're ladies, if you're on an older machine or you don't have software that has a basting stitch, Applique Corner offers free basting stitches on our Applique Corner Fanatics.
That's fantastic.
Page.
Oh, so my gosh, that's great to know that.
If you're on Facebook and not already on the page of Applique Corner Fanatics, you'll want to join that page. And up under and the top of the page, in the top right-hand corner, there's a file section. And there's all sorts of free files. And we, I have created many free basting stitches for
that
for
is
them
wonderful.
Too,
so. That is absolutely...
It's very helpful. Very helpful.
Oh, and so. I will remember that to share with others. So Applique Corner Fanatics.
That's okay. Right. That's right.
All right. Mm-hmm. By using that basting stitch now, it's going to hold that nice and secure. Otherwise, as this is stitching out, it will slide,
That's right.
Then your registration marks will not line up. Now, there's another really cool little thing.
I love the tape.
Oh, me too. And oh my gosh, this stuff is so wonderful. I used to use pink or the blue painter's tape that you were painting, and it leaves just the yuckiest residue. So you can take this and you can roll up your t-shirt. Now, I don't know, have you ever accidentally embroidered your arm on the back?
Many times.
Okay.
Many
haven't
times.
We all?
Or caught the edge of the back of the shirt. Oh, yes.
It's so frustrating.
Sure have.
Yes. So we're going to just take this and just kind of roll this all up and take and tape it right out of the way so that we don't have any issues whatsoever. And we'll just tear this off and tape this right down. And this is not going to leave any kind of a residue whatsoever. Of course, get rid of these arms so that you're not having that attached to the back of your embroidery design again. And fold that all up. And again, you can put another piece of tape down and tape this
That's
all out of the way.
Yep.
That's one use for wet and gone tacky. So would you like to see something totally different?
I would love to.
Off the wall.
Yeah.
All right. You know, I'm always wanting to branch out and do different fun things. So I'm going to reach across here and grab a couple of these to kind of share with you. Because this particular one here, you get that?
That's beautiful.
Well, you know what? This is kind of fun because every place you see the white, Kathy, I've made that fabric out of yarn and wet and gone tacky.
Oh, gorgeous.
Isn't that amazing?
Gorgeous.
And I think the fun thing about it is the texture. So this is using wet and gone tacky and yarn and making our own fabric.
Well, you and I both love to knit, but this is an easy way of knitting if you don't know how.
We do love to knit, but let me show you something else.
Gorgeous.
Because since we love to knit, Kathy, we could take and knit a scarf. Now, I realize you live in Florida. This may not be something you'll need, but there are other of you around the country that will.
Nice.
But look at this beautiful scarf.
That is just beautiful.
Now, Kathy, you and I, it would probably take us 2 to 3 weeks to knit this.
Exactly.
You can make one of these in about 2.5 hours.
Wow.
Using wet and gone tacky and using your machine to stitch this.
That is just gorgeous.
It's a lot of fun. And even take and make your fabric to make you a little, you know, bag or whatever to go with it.
Nice.
So I'm going to show you how easy this is. Now, I just did a little piece of fabric because I took the same yarn. I made all the fabric and made my daughter the little cutest shrug jacket out of this that was just adorable.
Nice.
So I just kept a piece of the fabric to show you. And doesn't that feel just like regular wool?
Really?
Isn't that amazing?
It does. It really
does. It's just so fun.
Who knew?
So I'm going to tell you how I've done this and how easy it is. Now, I've just done you a little short version of this.
Okay.
So I have laid my wet and gone tacky out. Now, remember, this is our sticky, pressure-sensitive, water-soluble stabilizer.
Right.
This scarf is 72 inches long. Now, you can do it whatever length, whatever width you want. Wet and gone tacky comes in a 9, a 12, and also a 20 inch. So I've just used the 12 inch roll on this, but I've just done a little sample, short one to show you how. I'll take a 72 inch long piece, put it on my cutting table, and I will peel all of the top off. So I have sticky exposed, all right? And it's still, it's on my table, so it's faced up, so the sticky is all exposed. And I will take Scotch tape it down so that it's not sliding all over.
Right.
I'm going to lay my yarns out. Now, Kathy, if you're making fabric such as this or in our table runner here.
Right.
You'd want your yarns to be closer together, wouldn't you?
Mm-hmm.
If you're doing a scarf, you could have it be open and airy,
yeah,
and it wouldn't really matter.
That's right.
So you could do scarves for warmth, or you could do scarves for just circling embellishment.
Right.
So when I laid these out, I probably, the biggest thing to remember, Kathy, is mm-hmm. not to stretch your yarn.
Okay.
So I took all of mine together. And so like if I was using, I believe there's like five different yarns in this.
Mm-hmm.
Take all the ends at one time, because believe me, if you do one at a time, oh my goodness. Major type A personality,
yes. Oh,
there's
goodness.
No way it would work for me.
Mm-hmm.
Take the ends, mm-hmm. and if you want a fringe, mm-hmm. you can leave 6 to 8 inches
yep.
on the end.
I like it like that.
Just lay it across, don't stretch mm-hmm. it, come down to the other side and leave 6 to 8 inches.
Mm-hmm.
Cover all of your yarn, and if you have holes in between, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, yeah.
Because it's doing a scarf, yeah. and you can see I've got some holes through here too
yeah.
as well.
Yep.
When you get all done with covering it mm-hmm. with your yarn, you need to put another piece of wet and gone tacky on the top.
Okay.
Now, don't do as I mm-hmm. did. Do not peel that next 72-inch piece off and think you're going to be perfectly laying that on top, because it will not happen.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
So, if you've ever hung wallpaper before or contact paper,
yeah.
okay,
yes.
take and peel back about 6,
yeah,
you know, make 10 inches, 12 inches, the sticky's exposed. Flip that over on top, because you know where the underneath
mm-hmm.
is.
Mm-hmm.
So just pull back, you know, 10 to 12 inches, line it up, and then reach underneath, pulling that across until you get the full 72
That's
inches
smart.
Covered.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now that we have this sandwiched in between mm-hmm. the two layers,
mm-hmm.
we need to sew this in order to
yeah.
keep it all held together when mm-hmm. we rinse it all out.
Nice.
Kathy, you can do free motion stippling, or
yep.
you can just take the width of your foot and do straight mm-hmm. stitches all the way across.
That's nice.
But if I do straight stitches, I do both
mm-hmm.
directions. I don't just do one direction.
Yep.
It's a great thing
yep.
to practice free motion stippling on, because
mm-hmm.
believe me, you'll be a pro by the time you
nice.
Get this 72 inches
nice.
By 12 inches
yeah.
done. All right?
Yeah.
So either way.
And Debbie, I'll also mention for the ladies who've started out on an embroidery machine and may not have a sewing machine yet, there are also free stippling designs on our Fanatics page.
That's so, fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, and so guess what?
Mm-hmm.
You and I have the new Destinies from
we
Baby
do.
Lock.
Yes, we do.
So you now have on this new mm-hmm. Baby Lock Destiny a 9.5 by 14 inch hoop.
Wow.
I know.
It's nice.
It is wonderful.
It is nice.
You can take mm-hmm. and do this and then put another piece of wet and gone tacky in your hoop,
mm-hmm.
lay this down, and go in and do the scanning
mm-hmm.
on the machine
mm-hmm.
and bring in all the stippling and let the machine do it for you.
Wow.
You don't have to do anything.
Yep. Nice.
Now, is that lazy or
That's
what?
That's nice.
You got it made. Okay. Then you would just simply keep
right.
moving it down
right.
till you got it all done.
Yeah.
But that's wonderful to know mm-hmm. that you have the stipplings on your applique.
We do, just in case, for those of you who may not have access to stippling designs or be able to, you know, work on a sewing machine, we do have those for your embroidery machine.
And so, you know, this is a fun yeah. project, because you don't have to have an embroidery
mm-hmm.
machine to do this.
That's right.
It's a great project.
I just love it. I'm so happy that you showed us this.
Well,
I'm going to have to make one.
I will tell you that my grandbabies have had a blast making these.
I bet they have.
This is a great sewing project
yes.
for your young girls that are learning how to sew,
yeah.
because it doesn't matter if their lines are straight.
That's right.
And they can sew to their little heart's content.
They could go pick out the yarns. I've got oodles and oodles of totes full of yarn, beautiful yarns. And that would be such a fun project.
Great project.
Yep.
Okay,
it.
So one more thing with our wet and gone tacky.
Okay.
All right, so wet and gone tacky, and we'll move these out of the way. Now, I like to mm-hmm. share, too, some of the new techniques that we're doing mm-hmm. with our wet and gone, because remember how I said about the lace, you had to have a freestanding design,
mm-hmm.
or otherwise
That's
it's
right.
going to fall apart.
That's right.
Well, Kathy, they have this wonderful little tool, and do you have one of these yet?
I don't have one yet, but I've had the pleasure of using one at one of our events, and I'm in love with it. I'm going to have
is.
To grab one.
And mm-hmm. I tell everybody I have to give my firstborn up before I would start with this. You know, that's a lie,
yep,
but
yep.
it is just the greatest thing ever.
It is.
And so
is.
Here's some of the mm-hmm. fun things you can do with
mm-hmm.
that. But the key part of this is nylon organza.
Okay. Okay.
So not mm-hmm. polyester organza. So you have to be a little select when you're out looking for your yep. organza, because it does need to be nylon. Mm-hmm. Polyester does not burn.
Okay.
And when you use, move this out of the way here so we can mm-hmm. do this. I've taken and made this table runner. So and if pretty. You look at the backside, Kathy, you're going to mm-hmm. notice that none of it's been embroidered onto it.
That's right. It has not.
So we can flip it over and wow. you can see that mm-hmm. I've just made all my little motifs yeah. using mm-hmm. one layer of wet and gone in the hoop. That's all I've used, yep. one layer of wet and gone. And then put a piece of nylon organza mm-hmm. over the top of my wet and gone.
Nice.
I'll stitch out my design. I'll leave it in the hoop. And then I will take this wonderful little tool mm-hmm. and just simply burn around the edge. Works fantastic. Nice. Now, on this design, Kathy, you'll mm-hmm. notice that if I had not had the organza, all my pieces would have just fallen apart.
Right, right.
It's holding it together.
Yeah.
But if you look on here, mm-hmm. you can't even hardly see.
Oh, I didn't even notice it was there.
You can't hardly yeah. see it at all.
That's right.
And this is nice. Such an awesome technique. Mm-hmm. Think about having to hoop this up and get this to be absolutely oh, perfect okay. to line this up. Mm-hmm. And one of the reasons I did this is because the design is falling off the edge. Mm-hmm. And then I've done this decorative stitch all the way around.
I love the three-dimensional effect that it gives.
It's just and a lot of
this
fun.
This would be a good technique for something that's difficult to stitch on, maybe a denim jacket or a bag
very
or something
much.
That's very thick and you can't get through. Just make your design and use the tool. That is so nice.
Well, it's
so
a great nice. Technique to do this. Mm-hmm. And this lay has been made with all these flowers with, nice. Again, one layer of wet and gone, mm-hmm. one layer of nylon organza. We spent a month over in Hawaii nice. Doing a dealer over there, Ricky mm-hmm. and Kay and my husband and I, so I made these for all of us. But look at these little flip-flops.
I love the flip-flops. I'm going to have to do
darling?
Some of these for my daughter.
Brooke would be
yes,
adorable.
She will love them.
Cutest can
she
be.
She would say she's fancy.
And they're so love easy to do. Those. Again, mm-hmm. one layer of the wet and gone mm-hmm. and one layer of the nylon organza. Now, after you burn this out, then you will just mm-hmm. take, just like we did the lace,
so
take
nice.
It over and just lightly rinse this out. Your wet and gone mm-hmm. will go away, and now you have the sheer mm-hmm. organza. Now this is a really good sample, and I didn't realize when I made this it would turn out to be mm-hmm. as cute as it was, but it's we'll kind of flat from in my suitcase, sorry
yeah,
about that. But
love that.
The reason I stitched it out like this is this design was not meant to be a freestanding design.
Mm-hmm.
This design is meant to be embroidered directly onto a piece of fabric.
Okay.
So without using the nylon organza, it would disintegrate.
Right.
So lately. I stitched it mm-hmm. onto the silk dupioni,
mm-hmm.
then I took and just did a freestanding one.
Beautiful.
So that's mm-hmm. just the wet and gone nylon organza. Yeah. Burned it out again, mm-hmm. and then I just glued it on with a glue gun.
Mm-hmm.
Now I've very taken nice. That same butterfly and done these darling little pendants.
Isn't that pretty?
By just doing two of them mm-hmm. and using fabric tack to glue them together. And this has been a lot of fun.
Nice.
So you can do this with
they're
so many fun
pretty.
Things. Mm-hmm. Of course, you got to have crystals.
So, oh, yes. Absolutely.
Got to have the bling.
More bling, the better. That's right.
Yeah. My
these
models.
These are so pretty.
I think they're darling.
You can hang them in a window or hang them on a china cabinet or a little doorknob. Or those are really pretty.
Aren't they cute?
Nice.
A lot of fun things to
now,
do
Debbie,
with
let
those.
Me ask you, you can use this tool for tags. We've got on Applique Corner, we have some luggage tags or backpack tags for children, some different patches that have like buttonholes so you can run ribbon through to put around a pillow. But couldn't you use the same tool to cut out those designs?
You bet you can. We're going to show you that in a segment a little bit later on.
Nice.
The big thing about this mm-hmm. is that it just has to be able to have a nylon base in it,
right.
and so it won't burn through everything. Mm-hmm. So understand it's not going to burn through, like silk, it will not burn
right.
through silk. If you use polyester, and a lot of you may have a stash of organza at home and you're mm-hmm. not sure which,
yep.
just take your tool along the edge of your salvage edge. You're going to know instantly mm-hmm. if it goes black and this doesn't want
right.
to move through it.
Right.
You're going to know that it's either silk or polyester.
Mm-hmm.
Organza, it just glides.
Mm-hmm.
So it works beautifully.
Nice.
But we're going to show you how to do patches.
Okay.
A lot of fun to do.
And let me ask too, a lot of ladies may be wondering, they may have some type of burn tool at home in their craft room from Michaels and Hobby Lobby.
Very
good. And we want to talk to them about the temperature of the specific temperature of this one.
So when I first started doing this, mm-hmm. I used one from one of the other vendors, and it was a 9-volt, mm-hmm. and it just doesn't mm-hmm. want to move, doesn't mm-hmm. want to glide. Mm-hmm. Well, I bought a wood burning tool, thinking a wood burning tool would work so good, and it started it on fire. So I don't recommend wood burning tools. I even had a lady ask me, what about a soldering iron? And I'm like, oh my goodness gracious, I don't think so. This is a 12-volt. Right. It's specially made for these types of things. So that's why this works so well. And this is our Floriani heat craft tool.
That's right.
Works absolutely beautiful. Right. Very inexpensive, but you could do so many fun things with this. Yeah. Now, I took, and on one of my projects, I taught at Martha Pullen, I had mm-hmm. some beautiful flowers, and I couldn't get this to burn through the silk. Mm-hmm. And so I went and cut them all out with scissors, but Kathy, it frayed so bad. So I thought, well, this mm-hmm. wouldn't burn through the silk. What if I just took and run around the edges and just mm-hmm. singed the edges mm-hmm. to get rid of all those little hairies? It worked fantastic.
Yep.
So there's more than one way to skin a cat.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right.
All right. So that pretty much covers our water soluble, except one.
Okay.
And that's our topping. Mm-hmm. Are you using a topping every time you embroidery?
Almost every time. Should I be every time?
Pretty close.
Yep.
Pretty close. Yep. Because the only time you really don't mm-hmm. is if you're doing a freestanding design, mm-hmm. like the little guy that I just showed you here, wherever he went to. Here he is. Mm-hmm. Freestanding design, no. Mm-hmm. But pretty much, yes, the rest of the time. Mm-hmm.
Well, one of the cool things that they make with Wet n Gone Tacky is the Wet n Gone Tacky tape. So this happens to be 1 inch, mm-hmm. but you could take an old rotary cutter and cut this down to be 1/2 inch, 1/4 inch. But a lot of people don't understand of how this can come in so mm-hmm. beneficial in things that they're doing. So by taking this tape, if you're joining your blocks, anytime you're butting up two blocks together, mm-hmm. and you're going to notice on the back the Wet n Gone Tacky tape. Well, what that does is it holds those blocks together, Kathy, because it's really hard to try to pin those. And then when you want to sew those together, it wants to slide and move you
Absolutely.
On you. Heirloom, like entredo, anytime you're doing any of like Martha Pullen's beautiful heirloom things and her entredo stitches, any of those heirloom stitches, mm-hmm. this Wet n Gone Tacky will hold that so perfectly and beautifully together. Now, I've got a couple samples here. Of course, this has all been done,
Beautiful.
And each one of these in the hoop. Mm-hmm. Well, rather than trying to make a seam allowance, I wanted to just join this together. So I've just butted these up together. And again, I put my Wet n Gone, Gone Tacky tape down and put them together. Mm-hmm. And then I've used another product called Applique Wonder that we're going to talk about that's fabulous.
Yeah.
This is one you guys are going to love.
Yeah.
And put it on the back of my lace.
Nice.
And covered up my mm-hmm. seam allowance. But that allows you to join those so you don't have that ridge mm-hmm. where it's joined. And here's another great sample. So I took this one down here and I actually left it so you could see. Now this is just a little finished one. But I've left all the step outs on this so you could actually see this. So here's my Wet n Gone Tacky tape, mm-hmm. keeping the two blocks joined together. Mm-hmm. And then you can see where I've actually zigzagged mm-hmm. those together, holding them. And then I've added my ribbon, added my lace.
Nice.
It works out beautifully. Mm-hmm. Makes a great table runner.
It's such a better alternative than pins, because the last thing you want to do is accidentally run over a pin with one of your machines.
That's right.
And
it's so hard to try to take and pin these two.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you got to pin and then go across and pin,
right.
and it never holds it. We used to use Scotch tape,
mm-hmm.
and then you'd have to peel it off as you go, trying to get all that tape out. But I've washed this, so when I got all done, of course, it just washed everything all the way.
It's so pretty.
So Wet n Gone Tacky tape is another great alternative to use.
What a great product.
It is a great product.
So we're going to show you water-soluble topping. And since we're doing toppings, Kathy, let's go ahead and talk about Heat n Gone.
Okay.
Even though it's not a water soluble, where the toppings, let's keep them together. Mm-hmm. Kind of looks like, I don't know, like saran wrap almost, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. But you can definitely feel the difference between water soluble and the heat and gone. Now, this is really soft. Mm-hmm. But when you feel this, you feel the little nubbies on the backside.
This one's a little bumpy.
Mm-hmm. Yes, so the heat and gone has nubbies on the back. Mm-hmm. So on your heat and gone, how would you think that would be removed?
I would say maybe an iron.
With heat. Mm-hmm. Right. That's right. Very good. Mm-hmm. So water soluble is going to be removed with?
Water.
Water. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I will tell you that the water soluble topping is the one and only that has any kind of a shelf life in our whole line. If you will just keep it, Kathy, in a Ziploc bag, it will last you a lifetime.
Yep.
And especially where you live in Florida and have a lot of humidity.
Humidity.
I really strongly recommend that you keep this in a Ziploc bag. Okay. I live in dry. I'm from Idaho. So this becomes very dry and very brittle where I live.
Yeah.
So I keep it in a Ziploc bag. Mm-hmm. It will last me indefinitely.
Nice.
Now, I think where people struggle the most on toppings is when do I use which one for which kind of fabric?
That's right.
What a topping does, just so that you understand, is it holds the stitches up on top of the fibers of the fabric. There's some fabrics that are much more suck that in till you can't see any definition in the embroidery design when you're done. And even on your beautiful appliques, Kathy, if you will use a topping on that, what it does is it seals that satin stitch all the way around it, making it more uniform. And when you pull that off, it sets that so that it will stay.
Yep.
So topping is very, very important. Yep. It used to be that we only used a topping on anything that had a nap or a pile to it. Now, this is probably one of the greatest samples I've ever made, to be honest with you, I had made these darling towels for my grandbabies, the hoods, you know, with the flower petals and all these darling designs. And when I went to babysit them, I had noticed that they all, the designs look like this, and it looked like I'd never used a topping.
Yeah.
Well, they weren't that old. They were only a couple of months old. So I'm thinking, why do these look so horrible? So I had used water soluble on all of my designs, thinking, okay,
that's right.
Stabilizer on the back, you know, I used the wet and gone tacky in the hoop, and then water soluble on top, it will just all go away. Well, it went all the way till it looked like this and looked like the designs were just horrid. Well, it just drove me crazy. So I went home and did the sample. So Kathy, this has been done with water soluble. Both of these have been done with heat and gone. When I got done with this, of course, I just removed the excess off. This one I took and removed the excess off. And like you said, on the heat and gone, we're going to take anything that's left, which is just going to be in the cracks or crevices. We're just going to remove it with the tip of an iron. Now, probably the biggest thing, ladies, is don't put the whole sole plate down on top. The tip. Just take just and just barely touch it. And you know what I've had a lot of people tell me, Kathy, is that those Clover craft irons that are pointed, they work really well to remove the excess away. It doesn't leave a residue on your iron, so you don't have to panic or worry that you're going to have all this stuff left. So when I got done with this one, I pulled it off and I removed what was left. But this one, I just cut it down. I wanted to see how this would withhold through the washer and through the dryer. I've washed this only 5 times.
Wow.
On a regular setting on my washer and warm water, and then on my dryer on the regular cotton setting.
Right.
5 times is all. So 5 washings through the dryer, 5 times. Look at how horrible this looks.
Isn't that something?
So water, water soluble goes away with water.
It goes away. It does.
So every time I wash this, of course, it removes it, it removes it, removes it. But look how nice the heat and gone. And this is what just amazed me, is that this withstood through the dryer, through the washer, and I still have it there after 5 washings.
Well, it would be heartbreaking. You spend all of your time. It's a labor of love, what we do for our friends and family or customers. And you spend all that time on sewing, and this looks like it's, you know, years old. It looks like it's been washed and worn many, many years, and just 5 times with water soluble. That's amazing.
And I can't tell you, Kathy, mm-hmm. how many towels I've done for wedding mm-hmm. gifts or for gifts for family mm-hmm. and used water soluble. Mm-hmm. I wanted to go back and contact every single person and say I'll redo them all. Because I can only imagine this is what they'd have to look like. Mm-hmm. So what this taught me is anything that has a nap, mm-hmm. anything that has a pile of any kind, mm-hmm. always use the heat and gun. And then it'll remain underneath the stitches. Right. It's not going to wash away. Right. And you'll end up with a beautiful stitched out design when you're done, mm-hmm. rather than having it wash away till you can't even see
this the looks design. Like this looks like it just came off the machine.
It's amazing, isn't it?
And I'll have to confess, I did not know this. I was one of those using water-soluble stabilizers.
So did
I,
Kathy.
Until I met you and until you shared this with me and I watched your videos and I had the same feeling. Wow. Years and years. 20 years of using.
I agree. So. But this, I guess we all learn the hard way, right?
We do.
And that's what we do. We all perfect. Don't think we sit here and know it all. No. We continue to learn so that we can help you.
Sorry.
To perfect and get better.
But you can save, you know, hundreds of dollars of mistakes by having the correct information and using the Floriani products.
And the correct stabilizers.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I don't know if you've ever used a heat product before, mm-hmm. that when you get done and you go to remove it away, you have all these little balls that form all around. Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's horrible. There's many heat products out there. When you go mm-hmm. to tear it off and you try to melt the rest of the way, you mm-hmm. just end up with all these little balls all around it.
That's right.
So this does not ball up mm-hmm. on you either.
We want to tell them when you use this product, the little nubbies go down.
Yes, thank you for reminding me.
Down towards the...
Those little nubbies are actually kind of for your... I call them little grippers.
Little grippers is what... It's exactly what it feels like.
Yeah.
It really does.
And so just like you said, mm-hmm. it should go always next to the fabric. Now, Kathy, there's one more little trick on this that's really cool.
Okay.
That'll help mm-hmm. too, because we do these wedding gifts, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But we really don't like all of the stabilizers showing on the back side.
Right.
But yet, to me, it's even more tacky to wash the towel before we give it and get rid of the stabilizer. That just, to me.
I agree. It's preference, I know, but I don't. I choose not to wash.
And I've even put little notes on there saying, mm-hmm. when this is washed, you know, this will be, you know, it'll be dissolved away.
I think we've all done that.
Okay, mm-hmm. so here's a cool little trick. Mm-hmm. If you're just doing, and you need to understand, this is just for like a monogram mm-hmm. or maybe for a name. It is not for a solid, dense design.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So if the design, any kind of density at all, this is not going to work.
Okay.
But what do we normally put on towels?
A topper.
Yeah, a monogram or a name.
Monogram. Yes, absolutely.
So
absolutely.
This works mm-hmm. so good for that. Mm-hmm. So all I've done is put mm-hmm. heat and gone in my hoop.
Nice.
So if the little nubbies go next to the fabric, you would hoop this up with the nubbies up, right?
Nubbies up on the back.
Right.
Nubbies down on the top.
So there's mm-hmm. the nubbies.
Right.
So that's all that's gone into my hoop. Now, mm-hmm. Kathy, I took and drew on directly to my wet and gone, or excuse me, my heat and gone, mm-hmm. my lines, just like I showed you a minute ago.
Right.
And you can see the lines mm-hmm. where I've drawn mm-hmm. on the towel. Mm-hmm. So this is in the hoop. Then I'll take and fold... Just like we showed a minute ago.
Right.
Fold and put this down and lay this all down. Now, I don't like spray adhesives. That's just my own personal opinion.
Yeah, not a
and
fan.
If you're going mm-hmm. to use spray adhesives, please take them away from your machine. Mm-hmm. Don't spray them next to your machine because it will gum up that upper tension so bad. And it will literally destroy your upper tension. Mm-hmm. So I don't use... spray adhesives.
Right.
I just rely on my wonderful pink embroidery mm-hmm. perfection tape. Mm-hmm. All right. Once I have this down and lined up, then I'll take my second piece mm-hmm. and lay on the top with the nubbies down again. Mm-hmm. So there's that, and it's starting to come out. I apologize. Mm-hmm. That wonderful basting feature again. And again, if you don't have the basting stitch built in your mm-hmm. machine, tell them where to go again.
Right. You can go to Applique Corner Fanatics Facebook page. And under the file section, there are free basting stitches as well as free stippling stitches and other designs.
So, fantastic.
Yeah.
A lot of the machines now mm-hmm. have the built-in basting stitch. So I'm just basting the layers together mm-hmm. so that won't move on me. Then when I get mm-hmm. my little monogram all stitched out, I'm going to take my basting stitch out. Mm-hmm. I'm going to pull off the top. I'm mm-hmm. going to pull off the back. All that's going to be left, Kathy, is just down in these little cracks here.
Yeah.
I can take the tip of my iron and mm-hmm. melt it away.
Melt it away.
And now I have no stabilizer showing on the back side whatsoever.
Nice.
And none on the mm-hmm. front. And you have a beautiful gift.
And you don't feel the need to either wash it or explain yourself or tell them to wash it.
Exactly.
That's nice.
It does. It works great. But again, not for a solid dense design. Only for a monogram or a name.
Understand.
All right.
Very nice.
Well, that's water solubles.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're wonderful.
Lots of great information to soak in. I know if you're like me, you'll watch this video and rewind it and watch it again and again. And just thank you so much for sharing your knowledge with us.
Wonderful.
Thank you.